Hey guys, and welcome back. I am Chris with Marksman Shooting Sports in Westfield, Indiana, and you are watching Marksman TV. Welcome back to another Gun Store vlog. Today I'm going to be talking about the NICS background check system, the background check that you go through to purchase a firearm. Big question I've been getting is, are they holding up people, delaying people, doing these sorts of things for the purposes of keeping people from buying firearms? I'm going to sort of talk about that misconception here in this video, give you guys a little bit more information on that. So if that sounds interesting to you, please stick around. That's coming up now. Okay guys, as you know, with all the purchasing that's been going on, especially, you know, starting off with the virus and then now with all the riots that are going on right now, we are undoubtedly in this huge purchasing phase. Lots of people panic buying, a little bit unsure about the situations going on. We are seeing record gun sales, and gun stores like mine continue to be basically stocked out of everything, out of stock of just about everything. Ammunition, firearms, if you're looking for it, it is really hard to get right now. I did a video about a week ago talking about wave two of the panic buying because of the riots and the looting and all of that. I told you guys I would give you an update to see if it was short-lived, if it was gonna calm down, and it definitely looks like it is still continuing. It is really hard for me to get things right now. That's probably gonna be continuing on at least through the summer. We'll see if we get this second virus wave to show up, or, you know, once we get into the election, I'm sure it's gonna continue to be pretty difficult, but there's your update on that. Now, one of the main types of questions I've been getting in a lot of these videos in the comment section is, is NICS still delaying people for 3 weeks? Is NICS holding people, holding guns hostage, not allowing people to get delays for the purposes of keeping people from buying firearms, okay? When you are purchasing a firearm, you do go through the background check system, and there's going to be two sets of laws that govern how quickly or when you can have that firearm. The first set is the federal laws, and the second set is going to be dictated by your local state laws. Now, here in Indiana, we don't have any type of state mandated waiting period. We don't have an ancillary state background check system. We don't have any of that. All of our purchases on firearms and all of that, when we do background checks on people, all of those laws are strictly federal. We just comply with the NICS background check system, and that is all we have to do to sell firearms to our customers. So I am only going to speak to that aspect of the background check system. Okay, so when you go into a gun store, you want to purchase a firearm. Many of you have been through this process. You're going to fill out either a paper 4473 form, or you're going to do it on a tablet, you know, electronically. It's all the same questions, and it's all basically the same process. Now, NICS, which is a National Instant Criminal Background Check System, they are run by the FBI. They are in a location. It is physical human beings that work there. When your dealer takes that information from you, your, let's just say a paper form, we've all done it in the past at some point in time, you have your paper form, you fill it out, you're going to include your personal information, your name, your address, social security number, if you want to include that. You're going to answer a series of questions. You're going to then sign and date it on the back. You're going to hand over your driver's license or ID to your dealer, who's going to record all a bunch of information, and then they're going to go transmit that information over to NICS. Now, the process can go in one of multiple different directions. The first thing is, they're going to input your information into the system, and if the system does not come back with any type of markers or red flags or concerns, they're going to just give you a proceed right away. The system has not changed, as far as I know, and at least in my experience, has not changed outside of that. So, you know, if I sell myself a gun, I still do a background check on myself to get, you know, that firearm logged out of my inventory. In that case, you know, as always been, I've always been lucky enough to just get a proceed right away. The other alternative that can happen, instead of, if you don't get a proceed instantly, you go to what's called further review or researching. If you call in the background check, they'll tell you on the phone, this is going to further review. If you're on a computer system, it's going to say researching. What that means is, the NICS data system, which is, again, all automated to begin with, that's the first process, is to run your information through the system under an automated basis to make sure there's no red flags, there's nobody in the criminal database that even closely resembles your information. If it's determined that there's nobody in there that looks like you, same last name, maybe same address, maybe same date of birth, a couple, I don't know exactly how it works, but enough similar markers to your information, it'll just give you a proceed, boom, you're done. Get your gun, you leave. Now, if you go to further review, what they actually need is what's basically happening is the automated system is saying, okay, there's a certain amount of markers here, maybe the last name and the first name are similar enough or the same to somebody who is in the database system as, you know, being a felon. They want to make sure that it's not you. Could be somebody that's got the same name, same date of birth, and was born in the same city and state, or the same state, they don't mark city. It's gonna mark you for review. What that means is you need an actual physical human being to review the file, okay? There are people who have to sort through that information. They are likely to call your local state police. They're going to do anything they can to verify that you are not who has been marked, or you could be marked because maybe you had you were arrested on a felony, but you weren't, you know, given the charges, or things were expunged. So you've been marked and flagged for some reason. They need a person to verify that you are not restricted from owning a firearm. That takes them time. Typically, and in most cases, when you're in a period of very low demand, that can be done quickly while the dealer waits on the phone, okay? So if you've been into a gun store before and it seems like you're waiting for 10, 15, 20 minutes, whereas your buddy just got to proceed instantly, that's why. There were some markers on your background check that were flagged for review. They have a person over at the NICS, at the FBI, the NICS system, that's personally viewing your file, maybe calling your local police, making sure that you aren't restricted. After 20 minutes, okay, they give you the proceed, you pay for your gun, you take it with you, you leave. Now, another outcome from a researching, and I find in my experience it's kind of like a 50-50, is they can move you to delay. And delays happen when maybe the results of their search, their quick search, is inconclusive and they need a little bit more time to review your file. Maybe the people that they need to call to look into your file are not available at the time, so they're putting you on review into a later date. Or, and in cases like what's going on now, the background check system, the people who are there, the tangible human beings who are looking into those further review statuses, they are so overwhelmed with checks that they're looking into, they don't have enough people staffed to handle it. What happens is all those people waiting in line are just gonna get pushed into a delay. Okay, so now you're delayed, and then this is usually the aggravating part. If you're delayed, that's when your dealer is gonna tell you, hey, you did get a delay. NICS system has a period of 3 business days, not including holidays and weekends, to come up with a status. Legally, they have to come up with that status within that period of time, or your status will move to open. During that delay period, what's gonna happen is the people at NICS are gonna continue to review your file. It will not always take up to that total 3 days. It could take 24 to 48 hours, is typically what I see. The status is returned. The dealer can call you up and say, hey, your status has been moved to proceed. Come on in, pick up your firearm. Now, if NICS does not complete that check within that 3-day period, it's actually technically 5, so it's the date of paper submission, 3 days in between, and the 5th day would be the date of transfer. So it's a total of 5 days if you include the date of paper submission and the date of pickup. Federally and legally, NICS only has 5 days to give you the status. That has not changed. So the question I'm getting is, NICS is holding my background check for 3 weeks. There's a little bit to that, but that is not a law. In that case, what is happening is your dealer is holding it, and I'll explain that. When your status moves to open, the dealer can legally transfer that firearm to you. NICS can only take that amount of time. They cannot hold your firearm on a review status indefinitely. That is deemed to be an abridgment of your Second Amendment rights. The reason that that was established when NICS was created was to reduce or eliminate the risk of governments are, you know, coming in and putting people on an indefinite delay, keeping them from enjoying their Second Amendment rights. So you have that 5-day period or 3 business day period in which they have to give you that status. If they do not give you that status within that period, your status moves to open. Again, that is the time in which the dealer can legally transfer that firearm to you, and that dealer is not breaking the law. Now, with that being said, there are a lot of dealers who do have a policy where they will not transfer that firearm to you once your status moves to open. They will want to wait for the status to move to proceed. So once your status moves to open, NICS will keep your file open and they will continue researching your background check for a period of 30 days. Once that 30 days expires, the whole transaction expires and you'll have to resubmit the paperwork again. That is totally up to it. We as FFLs are completely open to, for any reason, transferring firearms to anybody for any reason. We are not breaking the law in doing that. It is just policy. Some gun stores have that policy where they will not transfer that firearm to you unless they have a definitive and absolute proceed from the NICS system. It's a matter of either, if you want to call it morals, they don't want it, it's a morality issue, they don't want to transfer it, because there have been cases where somebody moves to open and then later it's determined that they were a prohibited person, and I'll get into that too. you know, you have to go through a bunch of things to get that taken care of. But if the FFL transfers a firearm to a prohibited person, but their status has been moved to open, the FFL is exonerated from any liability from having transferred that firearm. So in cases of people who are saying, you know, NICS is keeping my background check hostage for 3 weeks, and, you know, this is an abridgment of my rights, that is not actually NICS that is doing that. That is your dealer. But again, that's totally within their rights to do that. Now, some of these people who are leaving comments like this could be in states that require that there be a definitive proceed. They could be in states that require a secondary state background check, or they could be in states that require a mandatory amount of hold, like a 10-day hold on a firearm, like California, I believe, is that way. So that's just, again, federally. If you're in a state that has that type of restriction, I don't know about it. Indiana has no such restriction, so I'm not talking about anything like that. That'll vary on a state-by-state basis. If you live in a state where you're concerned if that sort of thing might be happening, or if you call the dealer after 3 weeks and say, hey, you know, is my status back? And they say, no, they're still researching, you might ask, does the state of whatever we live in, do they require a proceed on the background check? Does our state require a secondary background check? The gun dealer will either say yes or no, or you can contact an attorney or independent third party if you are unsure, or maybe just look it up on your state's website. Now, in the events of somebody getting a status moved to open, the gun dealer then sells them the gun, and then later the ATF calls or the status is moved to a denied. Now, we are a gun store where once your status is moved to open, we will sell you the firearm unless there's any reason for us to be concerned. But if we were concerned in the first place, we probably would have terminated the sale to begin with. We've only had it happen in one instance I can think of in the 6 years we've been open where we were given a status of open. We transfer the firearm to the person. The person was later denied. What happens is the ATF, your local field office, will say, hey, we had an open status, which has now been moved to denied. Did you transfer the firearm? We say, yes. They say, okay, do you have a way of contacting the person you transferred the firearm to? Typically, we would have had their phone number since they were delayed to begin with, so we can call them. In that case, we call the customer, we explain what happened, we ask that they bring it back. In that case, they did. Problem solved. We filled out a form, faxed it over to the ATF, and the case was closed. Not a problem. Person actually had no idea why they were denied. Again, your dealer does not know why you are delayed or denied. That's private information that they cannot tell us. If your status moves to open and you are a prohibited person, you know, don't be like, oh, you know, you get delayed and then they call you, come in and pick it up. Don't be like, oh, I fooled the NICS system. You know, it could still be that your status will move to denied. In which case the dealer is going to be contacting you to bring it back. If you refuse to bring it back, you've left all of your information on that background check, the dealer, the 4473 that the dealer has. That information will be provided to the ATF. We are required to give that information in such scenarios. They will use that information to track you down and get the gun back. They may also fine or arrest you for having completed the form feloniously if you, you know, because at the very top of the 4473, it does state if you lie on any part of the form, you can be in prison for up to 10 years and pay a $250,000 fine. So it is not something I would recommend trying to circumvent or fool. Yes, there have been people who fall through the cracks, but by and large, I like to hope that it's mostly usable, but it does have its faults, and that's one of them. Anyway, guys, that is the NICS system in a nutshell. No, NICS cannot legally hold you up for 3 weeks. It is likely your dealer or a state law that you are unaware of. Hopefully that dispels a lot of questions. Also, if you are new to firearms purchasing, that is a general idea of the sort of the process you're gonna go through the NICS background check system you're gonna have to complete in order to purchase a firearm, and that is federal, that is in all 50 states. I hope you guys found that interesting. If you did, please let me know by hitting that like button. If you have any questions about this process, please let me know by leaving them down in the comment section. And if you wanna see more videos like this, please consider subscribing to my channel so you can hopefully see more content like this in the future. I'm gonna leave you guys there. I am Chris with Marksman Shooting Sports in Westfield, Indiana. You are watching Marksman TV, and I will see you next time.